person. To talk about this, we have Ben Lewis. He is from Australia's SBS network. At this point in time, I think a lot of people are scratching their heads thinking, why is politics at this point in time right now in Australia such a blood sport?
Well, Paula, it's a tough business in Australia, politics at the best of times, but this week has been particularly brutal. Malcolm Turnbull was a relatively popular prime minister, but he was leading a government that had been struggling in the opinion polls for months now. And the challenge came earlier this week from his Home Affairs Minister, Peter Dutton, who's from the far right section of his own political party. Now, they mounted the challenge, they had a vote. Malcolm Turnbull won that, but then Peter Dutton came back a second time. This time, Prime Minister Turnbull put his hands up in the air and said, I don't want to take part in this anymore. Instead, his Treasurer, Scott Morrison, took part in the vote. He ended up winning it for the moderates, 45 votes to 40. So he's now the 30th Prime Minister of Australia, but he leads a party that's split down the middle and leads a government that only has a one-seat majority.
Yeah, that is a slim majority. If we get away from the politics and turn to policy, do you see any policy changes up ahead that people should worry about in Australia, or perhaps not worry about and cheer on?
Well, we haven't heard much about policy from the new Prime Minister, given that he didn't think he was going to be Prime Minister 48 hours ago, but he probably will have to make a few concessions to the hard right-leaning people in his party. Expect to see some changes to energy policy. Perhaps they'll weaken the focus on emissions targets. The big winner out of all of this, of course, though, is the Labor opposition. They, for the first time in a long time, will be able to present themselves as the stable alternative. And, of course, Australia has some huge problems going on at the moment with terms of the weather. They're in the middle of a critical drought. The Prime Minister is going to have a lot on his plate when he starts work.
Absolutely, to say the least. Appreciate that update from Australia. You are in London, we understand, but bringing us the very latest of what's going on down under.